automatic transmission torque converter components.
We're looking at a torque converter and an oil pump and a flex plate. Now, this is the oil pump drive mechanism on the torque converter housing, and we can see that it's slotted right here. And it sits on the oil pump in this fashion, and those slots fit right into the drive gear of this oil pump. So when this converter rotates from engine speed, we drive the drive gear on the oil pump. When we flip the torque converter over, this is called the button, and these bolt holes are for the flex plate to bolt up to. So the flex plate would bolt up to the torque converter in this fashion, and these bolt holes bolt up to the crankshaft. So the crankshaft will turn the flex plate, and the flex plate will turn the converter housing. The teeth on the outer part of the flex plate are for the starter gear. The flex plate is called a flex plate because it actually bows in and out a bit, or it flexes from the center part as it moves a tiny bit in and out. As the torque converter fills up with fluid, it bloats a little bit, as well as there's a little bit of crankshaft end play it has to compensate for. So we call this a flex plate. A lot of people will call this the flywheel, and it's technically a flex plate, but it will be universally called the flywheel as well, although that's not what it does. When we take the torque converter apart, we can see the inner workings of this torque converter, and on the inner part here is called the pump here, or the impeller. Sometimes called the impeller pump, but I prefer to just call it the impeller because students get confused with the oil pump that drives the transmission. Inside the impeller are these vanes for the fluid to flow through. We've got an inner set of vanes and an outer set of vanes, and they've got different angles to them. This one goes off this way and this one goes off that way. And this is the guide ring that helps guide the fluid in the inner around the guide ring, and it comes out the outer portion right in here. Next comes the turbine, and the turbine is actually separate from the housing, so I can hold the housing and turn the turbine separate. The splines right in here go right into the input shaft. So this is my transmission input shaft with my forward clutch, and there's my input ring gear right there. And so these splines on the turbine, they connect directly to that input shaft. So if I turn the turbine, I turn the input shaft into the transmission. This would be comparable if you are used to a standard clutch mechanism, where this would be your clutch disc and this would be your transmission input shaft. On the back side of this turbine is the lockup clutch dampener springs. And so we've got these dampener springs built in with these tabs here. And then we have what's known as the lockup piston. And that lockup piston here is tabbed to this mechanism. And there's a smooth surface on this lockup piston, but when it's applied, it'll force itself up against the converter housing here. And there's friction material right here that it rides up against. So once we take this lockup piston and force it against the housing with hydraulic pressure, it will lock the two together and they will turn as one. That way we can direct drive from the engine to the transmission input shaft, eliminating any slippage, gaining us in gas mileage. So once we pull the impeller off, I didn't have the stator in there before, but this is the stator mechanism, and this controls fluid flow to the inner part, or from the turbine back to the impeller. And so as fluid is transferring between these two objects, it's going to go through this stator mechanism. Now, the stator has a one-way clutch built into it, so it can free spin in one direction and lock in the other direction. Now, this is actually going to be coming from part of this pump mechanism. So this is my oil pump, and this is half of that oil pump, and this shaft is called the stator shaft. We call that the stator shaft because these splines will lock right onto that stator there. Now, that's an inner race of a one-way clutch, and that allows this stator to free spin in one direction, but if I try to turn it in the other direction, it's going to lock. So it locks up like that. And the way this would actually look is that it's going to be coming from the pump side. It's going to be coming through there just like that, coming into the transmission housing and right there to that stator mechanism there, or that one-way clutch. If we wanted to build this a little bit further, your input shaft would be coming from this side as well, and it would show up just like this, but that would come through like this. So there would be your input shaft. Let's get it from the side a little bit. And there's my stator shaft, so my stator goes on in that fashion. And then your impeller is going to come over, and it's going to spline right to that input shaft. And now we have a separate turning turbine on the input shaft, and the housing can turn independently. And as the housing turns, the pump's going to turn, but the two can turn separately. Then your lockup piston would go on to your turbine. And I want to point out to you, there's actually an oil seal right here in the end of that turbine. And this oil seal is going to hold pressure. And then there's a seal on the outside here that seals right on the inside of this piston. Then when the two go in like this, we're going to bring oil pressure from the transmission in through the center here, and it can come out and it can push against this piston area, and it'll push the piston away from the housing. That's when we don't want lockup. When we do want lockup, we're going to bring fluid in from this side, and it's going to push the piston up against the housing, and that gives us our lockup mechanism. So I just want to take another minute to show you a few different designs. This is a different torque converter housing cover, and notice that the starter teeth is part of this housing cover. And there's the bolt holes right there for the torque converter flex plate. Those are the bolt holes for the flex plate. And what's unique about this is these holes are really shallow. And so the bolts that go in here are special bolts of a really short length. And this particular one, if we want to look right here, you can see where I've got it circled right here. That's where one of the bolt holes is on the other side. And what happened is someone put too long of a bolt in there. So if I catch the light just right, you can see that it's sticking up. And of course, this is where the lockup piston rides on, and it has to be smooth. So when the lockup piston started to hit this housing, it was bouncing up and down, causing a chatter, because that bolt hole was dimpled because someone put the wrong size bolt in here. They put too long of a bolt. So that's something to be careful of. So let's just take a look at one other type of torque converter, and notice that we've got no drive for the oil pump on the front of this one here. And when we pull this off, we do see something similar. So there's my impeller, has your guide rings, and it has the vanes on it. And here's my stator with the one-way clutch built into it. and my turbine, and my turbine has the splines for the input shaft. It's a little hard to see way down in there, but we can see that we do have some splines down in here. That's for my input shaft. You can see the oil ring right here. This is an O-ring for the lockup piston mechanism. That's going to seal that out. But I do want to show you the lockup piston is a little bit different on this one. The dampener springs are built into the piston, so those are right there. And the piston has the friction material on the piston instead of on the housing. And the housing on this one is smooth. So there's a slight bit of difference. The way it attaches to your turbine is a little bit different as well. There's no big tabs on the outside. Instead, there's a big set of splines right here on the inside. And those splines will match up with splines on your turbine right here. And so they'll match together like this. Application is very similar. If you want to apply this piston, you bring hydraulic fluid pressure between the turbine and the piston, and the piston will move outwards against the housing. If you want to keep the pressure off or the lockup converter off, you bring fluid pressure on this side of the piston where it gets in between the housing and the piston, and then it'll keep the piston from touching the housing. There's only a few thousandths of an inch there. Now, where's the oil drive on this one? Well, we've got an oil drive spline in the bottom of this torque converter housing. It fits down inside the button right in here. And let's see if we can get some pictures of some light down in here and see that. Really hard to see, but there are some splines right down inside there. And there's a shaft, and we use what's known as an oil pump drive shaft, which looks something like this. This is not the exact one for this, but it's similar. And this will fit right down in these splines right down in here. And that'll allow us to turn this housing. So when this housing turns, this drive shaft turns. And at the other end of this drive shaft, another set of splines. And those splines go on the oil pump drive gear. So this is how the oil pressure gets driven from the torque converter in this particular design. And it all goes in like this. And this drive shaft will go right through the input shaft all the way out to the back of the transmission, or the back of the transaxle actually is where it's going to. And then there'll be an oil pump that'll be bolted up back here, and this will connect to that oil pump drive gear.